Hello, my name is Ruth, a PhD student from the Hebrew University, and I'm delighted to discuss with you today our JXMed paper titled The Lifespan and Kinetics of Human Dendritic Cell Subsets and Their Precursor in Health and Inflammation. Dendritic cells act as a critical bridge between the innate recognition of antigen and the induction of adaptive immunity. Under healthy homeostasis, DC comprises two distinct lineages: plasmacytoid dendritic cells, or PDCs, and conventional dendritic cells, or CDCs. They can be categorized into three groups: CDC1, DC2, and DC3. DC3 exhibit multiple similarities with DC2, but they are understood to have a distinct ontogeny. Lastly, another member of the DC family is the Axl positive Siglec-6 positive DCs, or ASDCs, also designated as pre-DCs, DC5, or TDCs. To investigate the lifespan of blood CDC subsets during healthy homeostasis, we use the non-toxic stable isotope labeling approach, specifically by using deuterium-labeled glucose. Deuterium is a stable isotope of hydrogen, which can be stably incorporated into the backbone of DNA in dividing cells. Therefore, it acts like a birth certificate. Following the administration of deuterium-labeled glucose to healthy volunteers, we analyze sorted DC subsets at sequential time points, looking for DNA deuterium incorporation by mass spectrometry. Strikingly, ASDCs appeared in the circulation as early as 6 hours post-labeling, suggesting a very short post-mitotic dwell time in the bone marrow prior to entering the circulation. These ASDCs then followed a similar kinetic trajectory to the other CDC subsets, which appeared 1 day post-deuterium pulse. To gain further insight into these kinetic profiles, the deuterium data, together with other data sets, were examined with several mathematical models predicting the lifespan of each of the CDC subsets. After generating few possible models and performing the appropriate calculation, the most likely model was chosen. Altogether, these data predict the average circulating lifespan of ASDC to be at around 2.1 days, CDC1 for 1.3 days, and DC2 and DC3 for 2.2 and 2.3 days, respectively. To investigate the role of the circulating CDC compartment during inflammation, we used a human experimental skin blister model to examine the kinetics and functions of DC subset in response to a bacterial insult in healthy individuals. A blister was provoked following an intradermal injection of dead E. coli into the forearm of healthy volunteers, and the blister content was then examined by flow cytometry and single-cell RNA sequencing. It was possible to identify all DC population in the blister by 24 hours. Curiously, we observed a considerable influx of ASDC to the inflammatory site compared with their blood counterparts, which suggests a unique role of ASDCs as an effector cells when recruited to the site of inflammation. Therefore, we compared the differentially expressed genes between blood and blister ASDCs and, as expected, identified several pro-inflammatory genes that were upregulated in the blister ASDCs. In contrast, a dramatic reduction in several HLA molecules was observed. Few of the upregulated genes in the blister ASDCs pointed toward an activated interferon beta or IFN beta pathway. Therefore, we tested the impact of IFN beta on ASDCs antigen presentation capacity, a pathway significantly reduced in blister ASDCs. And indeed, the presence of IFN beta reduced the ability of ASDCs to stimulate the proliferation of naive allogenic T cells in the mixed leukocyte reaction. Interestingly, these T cells produced more IL-10. Taking together, these data demonstrate that ASDCs can adopt an inflammatory phenotype with potential effector functions. Lastly, I would like to thank our funders and all of our volunteers. I hope you enjoyed this quick recap of our paper, and if you want to know more about it, please check it out in the link. Thank you for listening.